Michigan's honeybees and climate change. Bees play a big role in our agriculture, but climate change is threatening these critical food workers. First Warn 5 Chief Meteorologist Brian Bachman spoke with local bee experts about how weather affects their lives.
A juicy Honeycrisp apple, a homegrown treat here in Michigan, and just one of many varieties produced by our state's apple industry. But our farmers wouldn't be able to bring these to us without some helpers who create quite a buzz. Honeybees. These flying, hive-building insects can be found on every continent on Earth except Antarctica. They're foragers that live on a diet of pollen and plant nectar, which they use to make the honey that, of course, we love to put in our coffee and tea.
The insect that we're looking at right here are called European honeybees.
Elly Maxwell is an entomologist who teaches a beekeeping series at Dow Gardens and oversees the hives of hardworking honeybees who live in Whiting Forest.
In a honeybee hive, we have three kinds of bees. We have 25 or 30,000 worker bees.
Worker bees are all female, and they do just about everything in the hive, from feeding the young to cleaning the hive and foraging for food. Armed with barbed stingers, they are also responsible for defending the hive. So what about their male counterparts?
Then we have hundreds or dozens of drones, which are the male bees.
Drones are identifiable by their larger size, but don't expect to see them putting in much work.
Not only are they lazy and not contribute much to the work around the hive, but the male bees also have no stingers.
But whether you're a drone or a worker, there's only one head honcho in the hive. That, of course, is the queen bee. And she calls all the shots.
Her pheromones that dictate whether they need more larvae, more brood, where they're going to be working, whether they're gearing up to swarm.
The queen puts her bees to work, but what does that work entail?
Bees forage for four things. They forage for nectar to make honey, forage for the pollen to provide protein for their babies. They bring in tree sap to make the sticky propolis.
Propolis being a substance that both disinfects and seals the hive.
And they do forage for and bring in water.
All that foraging helps to grow and sustain the hive, but its benefits go beyond the lives of the bees themselves.
Bees are our best pollinators.
By foraging for the nectar and flowers, honeybees also pick up pollen and transfer it to other plants as they go.
They're responsible for the apple crop that we're hopefully going to get on our trees this year.
Now, being a meteorologist, you know I needed to look into what role the weather plays in the lives of honeybees. And as it turns out, there's a lot to it.
When we have these very long days, they get very long work days foraging in the fields. So it's prime time for making honey, and the weather dictates a lot of that.
Like humans, honeybees are known to be a bit more irritable on hot days, and they aren't big fans of heading out in less than ideal weather conditions either.
They don't like to fly when it's less than 50 degrees. They don't like to fly when it's windy and rainy and miserable out.
Travel and work aren't the only aspects of hive life where weather plays a role. The queen's ability to reproduce is also one where weather has a hand on the steering wheel.
In February and March, when we start to get longer days, we can look in a hive and see that she is laying eggs.
Weather looms large in the lives and productivity of honeybees, and with that, so does the specter of climate change. A warming climate could make it too hot for honeybees to survive in certain regions, either killing them outright or forcing them to move to milder regions. At the end of the day, the honeybee population needs our help just as much as we need theirs.
It takes many years to adapt to changes, so they really rely on the beekeeper to help them.
And while the issues posed by climate change will of course be a larger scale issue and take time to address, one of the simplest things you can do to protect our honeybee friends is to remember that if you ever encounter a swarm on your property or potentially in your home, it's always important to call a beekeeper to have them safely relocated. I'm Chief Meteorologist Brian Bachman, WNEM TV5.